The Rougarou is a legendary creature deeply rooted in the folklore of Louisiana's Cajun and Creole cultures, particularly in the Acadiana region. This mythical being is often described as a shapeshifter, possessing characteristics of both a human and a wolf or dog. While it shares some similarities with the European werewolf legend, the Rougarou has its own unique Louisiana twist. Legend has it that the Rougarou has the supernatural ability to switch between its human and wolf-like forms. During the day, it typically maintains a human appearance, but come nightfall, it transforms into its menacing wolf-like self. This transformation is often attributed to a curse or a pact with the devil, and it can last for a specific period, often said to be 101 days. The Rougarou, in its wolf-like form, is described as having fur, sharp teeth, and glowing red eyes, creating an aura of fear and dread. In its human guise, it appears just like any other ordinary person, making it difficult to identify. La Santa Compaña, also known as the Holy Company or the Holy Procession, is a mythological and folkloric belief from Galicia, a region in northwestern Spain. It is a legend and superstition deeply ingrained in the cultural traditions of the area. According to the legend, La Santa Compaña is a procession of souls of the dead or spirits who are said to roam the streets at night, typically during the hours of darkness. The procession is said to be led by a living person who is unaware of their role in the procession. This living leader is often considered cursed and must bear a burden of leading the spirits until they can find a replacement or perform certain rituals to break the curse. Members of La Santa Compaña are typically depicted as carrying candles, crosses, and other religious symbols, and they may sing or chant as they move through the streets. They are believed to be on a journey to guide the souls of the deceased to the afterlife. Encountering La Santa Compaña is considered ominous, and it is believed to bring misfortune or even death to those who witness it. To avoid this, locals take various precautions, such as staying indoors after dark, drawing protective symbols on their doorways, or leaving offerings to the spirits. La Santa Compaña is a rich and complex part of Galician folklore and has been the subject of various stories, poems, and cultural expressions. It reflects the blending of Celtic and Christian traditions in the region and remains an intriguing and eerie aspect of Galician mythology and superstition. La Sayona is a legendary figure in Venezuelan folklore and mythology. She is often depicted as a vengeful and malevolent spirit or ghostly woman who seeks to punish unfaithful or dishonest men. The legend of La Sayona is part of a broader tradition of ghost stories and supernatural tales in Latin American and Caribbean culture. According to the legend, La Sayona is a woman who was wronged by a man, often in the context of a romantic relationship. In some versions of the story, she was betrayed, abandoned, or mistreated by her husband or lover, leading to her untimely death. In death, she returns as a vengeful spirit, typically appearing as a beautiful woman dressed in white with long black hair, but her face is hidden by a veil or shroud. She is said to wander the streets and countryside, searching for unfaithful men to exact her revenge upon. La Sayona's modus operandi usually involves seducing the unfaithful man, leading him into a remote area, and then revealing her true terrifying form before subjecting him to various forms of punishment or torment. Her goal is to make the man suffer for his betrayal or infidelity. El Silbón, also known as the Whistler, is a legendary figure in Venezuelan folklore. This sinister character is often portrayed as a tall, emaciated man dressed in ragged clothing. What makes El Silbón particularly eerie is his habit of whistling as he approaches his victims. The legend of El Silbón is commonly told as a cautionary tale to scare children and young people, warning them to be respectful and well-behaved. The most common version of the story revolves around a young man who killed his father for not preparing his favorite meal. In retaliation, the boy's grandfather administered a gruesome punishment by flogging him mercilessly and then making him consume the father's liver. The grandfather then placed a curse on the boy, condemning him to forever wander the night, whistling ominously and carrying his father's bones in a bag. The legend serves as a morality tale, emphasizing the importance of respecting one's parents and not indulging in acts of violence or cruelty. El Silbón is often used by parents and elders to discourage misbehavior in their children, warning them that the whistler may come for them if they do not behave appropriately. Robert the Doll is a haunted and allegedly cursed doll that has become a popular legend in Key West, Florida. The doll is said to be possessed by a spirit or have some supernatural powers. It is known for its eerie appearance and the various stories and legends associated with it. The doll stands about 40 inches tall and is dressed in a sailor suit. It was originally owned by a boy named Robert Eugene Otto, who was given the doll by a family servant in the early 1900s. The doll was named after the boy and became his constant companion. Strange events were said to occur in the presence of the doll, including furniture being moved, objects being rearranged, and eerie giggles and whispers. It is believed that the doll is cursed. Many people who have visited the East Martello Museum, where the doll is now on display, claim to have had strange and unsettling experiences. According to legend, if you want to take a photograph of the doll, you must ask politely. Failing to do so is said to result in bad luck.